Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Today, and we're back again with some latest updates for you, and all the three updates today are regarding SpaceX. All the SpaceX fans out there who are disappointed with Starship SN9's back-to-back delay can be happy to know that SpaceX's new Starship test tank has passed its first trial. Recently, Starship SN9's high-altitude flight test was delayed by a lack of FAA approval for unknown reasons. The launch has been delayed from the beginning of this week. Meanwhile, SpaceX found a way to use some time conducting the first Starship test tank stress test in months. SpaceX's latest Starship test tank, known as SN7.2, is the successor of its previous lineup, SN7.0 and SN7.1. As per that, SN7.2 is also built from the same alloy used in the previous test tanks. On Tuesday, Michael Baylor tweeted, SpaceX is conducting testing with the SN7.2 3mm test tank today in Boca Chica. Teams are likely to follow a similar routine as the previous SN7 test tanks with multiple rounds of proof testing, followed by a pressurized to failure test. As per the update, SpaceX began filling the tank with liquid nitrogen at around 9 a.m. Central Standard Time. The liquid nitrogen will simulate cryogenic propellant without the risk of an explosion. The initial pressure test went around 3 hours, which SN7.2 survived. More likely, this test is to raise the tank's internal pressure to the same level achieved by its predecessor tanks. According to Musk, 6 bar is the minimum value for orbital flight, but a required value to achieve an industry-level safety margin of 25 to 40% is around 7.5 to 8.5 bar. The next day, Michael tweeted, "The first cryogenic proof test appears to have been a pass, although no way to know for sure without an official word," which about 2 hours later, Musk confirmed on Twitter, "Passed initial pressure test." Now for the next test, SpaceX might pressurize the tank to its limit until it bursts, which is to check the performance of SN7.2's thinner skin. Stay tuned for exclusive updates. Now we'll move to the next segment of our news based on SpaceX's Super Heavy booster update. With ongoing Starship preparations and tests, side by side, SpaceX is also focusing on the construction of Starship first stage, i.e. the Super Heavy booster. Till now, it's reported that 2 prototypes of Super Heavy booster are undergoing stacking procedure. SpaceX is significantly making use of the experiences it earned through the course of construction, assembling, testing, and flying of its previous Starship prototypes, and they're using those experiences for building upgraded Starship and Super Heavy prototypes. On the 25th of January, 2021, for the first time, a significant part of SpaceX's Super Heavy booster prototype has appeared at the company's South Texas Starship factory, Boca Chica. SpaceX is very much capable of using practical, indistinguishable equipments, apparatus, gears, and modus operandi for manufacturing and assembling propellant tank barrels and domes for both the Starship and the Super Heavy. SpaceX teams will work out extensive foundation of avionics, propulsion, ground systems, and plumbing for the twin-stage Starship. Super Heavy, with its 28 Raptor engines and superior thrust structure, will be the largest, highly advanced, and strongest liquid-fueled rocket booster in the world upon completion. SpaceX will embark on with using the same non-explosive methods they've previously used for Starship prototypes. SpaceX teams at Boca Chica site, accumulating series of hydraulic rams to build a larger and stronger test stand to bear the thrust of 28 Raptor engines of Super Heavy booster. Recently, a steel structure has been seen during a recent aerial overflight of SpaceX's Starship factory. RGV Aerial Photography has tweeted on the 25th of January, "Could this new stand be for SH?" They have also posted the picture of the structure. Construction of Super Heavy have started just a few days ago. Very soon, the most crucial part of BN1, i.e. the thrust dome, has appeared. It's expected that the first booster could be fully assembled and ready for testing within a short period of time. Starship second stage uses a small central thrust puck fit for three sea-level optimized Raptor engines. And it has future intentions of three larger vacuum-optimized engines that will fasten to the edge of its hull. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk had previously stated that the Super Heavy would have a central cluster of eight engines, but the specific pattern is not disclosed till now. In the recently captured photos, which were taken by photographers Jack Beyer, Mary of Boca Chica Gale, and also by NASASPACEFLIGHT, shows a much larger donut-shaped steel ring with room for eight gimbaling Raptor engines. There are chances of installing remaining 20 Raptor engines in the skirt or in the thrust dome. They can also be installed in the space left between the thrust donut and Super Heavy skirt. Jack Beyer of NASASPACEFLIGHT tweeted on the 25th of January with posting a photo of BN-1's tank dome. "Oh hey, Super Heavy booster number 1's aft dome. Looks like spots for four Raptors. Neat." Super Heavy is less complicated than the Starships, and they didn't configure a conical nose, flaps, header propellant tanks, heat shield, and vacuum-optimized Raptor engines. It will only have grid fins for guiding atmospheric re-entry. The Super Heavy booster will produce at least 6,600 metric tons of thrust at liftoff, which is almost triple the thrust of Falcon Heavy and double the thrust force of Saturn V and Soviet N1 rockets. So the donut-shaped steel structure and the dome at the back of the two rings of Raptor engines should have the capability to withstand such thrust. The steel structure will also have to single-handedly bear up to 1,600 tons of thrust. On the other hand, it will also withstand gravity, acceleration, and some 2,500 tons of subcooled liquid oxygen push in the reverse way. The making of Super Heavy is an extraordinarily difficult task for SpaceX. SpaceX has already started to build the first true-to-life prototype, with goal of recreating more models in the future. SpaceX is expected to focus to the Super Heavy's first test campaign, along with stressing the rocket's thrust structure design, when prototype booster number 1, BN-1, successfully passes through the basic pressure and cryogenic proof tests. Let's move to the last segment for today. SpaceX has already taken the next step of their Starlink broadband program by launching 10 Starlink to the polar orbit, which were equipped with laser crosslinks. Recently, SpaceX conducted the record-breaking Transporter 1 launch, where SpaceX launched a total of 143 satellites, including their own Starlink satellites. It was under their Starlink constellation program. Now, SpaceX launches a batch of Starlink satellites once in a month, but the launch in Transporter 1 mission was different from other Starlink launches. On that mission, SpaceX launched the first Starlink satellites to polar orbit, which are equipped with laser crosslinks. After the launch of Transporter 1 mission, CEO of SpaceX, Elon Musk, said in a tweet that those Starlink satellites were equipped with laser inter-satellite links. These also have laser links between the satellites, so no ground stations are needed over the poles, Musk tweeted. Now, inter-satellite laser crosslinks is a technology which provides a better way of communication with increased data throughput. This type of technology uses the advantage of its small wavelength and low beam divergence and sends highly directed signals over relatively long distances. SpaceX further plans to use this technology on other Starlink satellites next year. Musk himself shared the news of Starlink satellite equipped with laser crosslink technology would launch next year. All sats launched next year will have laser links. Only our polar sats have lasers this year and our V0.9, Musk said in a tweet. By launching Starlink satellites equipped with laser crosslink to polar orbit, SpaceX targets to maximize internet connection in Alaska and minimize the needs for ground stations. According to SpaceX, Starlink laser links allow it to share communication without the assistance of ground stations in remote areas. As a result, it will significantly expand the range of availability of Starlink internet connection in many narrow areas. In addition, it will provide the connection with minimal latency because the number of hops between satellites and ground stations are reduced. According to the information, SpaceX has been testing inter-satellite links on other Starlink satellites for a while now. As Musk said in a previous tweet, these satellites will launch next year. SpaceX also said they tested space lasers between two satellites, relaying hundreds of gigabytes of data. Once these space lasers are fully deployed, Starlink will be one of the fastest options available to transfer data around the world, SpaceX stated in a webcast. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.